Hi, welcome to Living Tech. In this video tutorial, we're going to show you how to set up a virtual machine using VirtualBox from Sun Microsystems. Setting up this virtual machine will provide hands-on training without the risk of damaging the computer system if something wrong happens. Since the working environment is virtualized, everything we do will reside in its own virtual space that's separate from the rest of the main operating system. To start this tutorial, first run the VirtualBox application. This is what VirtualBox will look like after we open up the program. As we can see, there are no virtual machines that exist inside our VirtualBox yet. To create a virtual machine, let's begin by clicking on the New button. Then click Next to continue with the installation. This is where we can name our virtual machine and select which operating system to run inside our virtual machine. This drop-down box allows us to install any operating system we want. This box allows us to pick which version of the operating system, like Windows XP or Windows 7. Since we're going to install Windows Server 2008, we will name this virtual machine Windows Server 2008. Then click on the Operating System drop-down box and select Microsoft Windows. On the Version drop-down box, select Windows 2008. Click Next to go to the next step. This screen allows you to set the maximum amount of memory that the virtual machine could use. You can stick with the recommended settings or increase the memory size depending on your needs. In this case, we're going to dedicate 512 MB of RAM to our virtual machine. Keep in mind that the more memory we give to our virtual machine, the smoother our virtual machine will run. If your computer has very little memory, you can stick with the recommended settings. Then click on Next to go to the next step. This screen allows us to create space inside our hard drive to install a virtual machine. Make sure the boot hard disk option is checked. And then click on the Create New Hard Disk option. Then click on Next. Click Next to continue. On this screen, we can choose either dynamically expanding storage or fixed size storage. The dynamically expanding storage option allows us to automatically expand our virtual space as we are adding more files, documents, and programs. Fixed size storage allows us to specify a fixed amount of virtual space that our virtual machines can use. It's best to select the dynamically expanding storage option because there is no virtual space limitation. Our virtual machine can use more virtual space in the future if needed. Go ahead and click on Next. Under Location box, we can change the folder location of our virtual space by clicking on the yellow folder icon to the right. In our case, we're going to keep it at the default location. Next, we're going to specify the amount of virtual space that our virtual machine will use. In our tutorial, we're going to use 20 GB for virtual space because we want to allow more room for installation purposes. This does not mean that our virtual machine will use a certain amount of fixed virtual space, but rather it tells our operating system that our virtual machine requires 20 GB to run. Since we chose a dynamically expanding storage option, our virtual space will expand if more space is required. Click on Next and you will see the summary of the virtual space that we're going to create. Go ahead and click on Finish. And then click on Finish again to finish creating our Windows Server 2008 virtual machine. When the setup is finished, the section on the right-hand side gives us details about our computer, such as RAM, hard drive space, operating system, video memory, and so on. Looking to the left, we can see our Windows Server 2008 virtual machine that was just created. Currently, it is in a powered-off mode. Now, we can click on the Start button to install Windows Server 2008 to our virtual machine. We hope you enjoyed this video tutorial by Living Tech.